Metals have one, two, or three electrons in their outermost shell, and these electrons are known as valence electrons, whereas non-metals have 4 to 8 valence electrons. Each and every element have a tendency to acquire noble gas configuration. What is noble gas configuration? That their outermost shell must be completely filled, or there are 8 electrons in their outermost shell. As only 1, 2, 3 electrons are present in outermost shell of metals, so they have a tendency to lose electrons while they react with any other element. So they always form electropositive ions, or they are electropositive in nature. Elements which lose electrons during chemical reaction are electropositive in nature. In case of non-metals, because 4 to 8 electrons are present, so they have a tendency to gain electrons to complete their octet, means to complete their outermost shell. This is the reason that non-metals are electronegative in nature. It means when they react with any other element, they have a tendency to gain electron. So metals have tendency to lose electrons, and non-metals have tendency to gain electron. And this is the basic concept of formation of ionic compounds. For example, first element is sodium. Its atomic number of sodium is 11. Okay children, atomic number 11 means it has 11 electrons, okay, and 11 protons in one atom. Now, if we write electronic configuration of these 11 electrons, it would be like this: 2, 8, and 1. It means its first shell, means K shell, it has 2 electrons. L shell, it has 8 electrons, and M shell, it has only 1 electron. Okay, because M shell is the last shell, so this is called as valence shell. This is called as valence shell. Okay, and this electron which is present in valence shell is called as valence electron. So how many valence electrons sodium has? Sodium has only one valence electron. Clear children? Now, second element, if we take chlorine. Symbol of chlorine is Cl, and its atomic number is 17. Atomic number of chlorine is 17. Electronic configuration of chlorine means distribution of electrons in various shells is something like this: 2, 8, 7. Its K shell has 2 electrons, its L shell has 8 electrons, and M shell has 7 electrons. So which one is outermost shell here? M shell is the outermost shell. So this is also known as valence shell, and 7 is the number of valence electrons. Now let us draw the electron dot structure of this one, sodium. While writing the electron dot structure, we always mention only valence electrons. So how many valence electrons are there in sodium? Only one. And this electron can be shown with the help of dot or cross. It's up to you that which symbol you want to use. Now, electron dot structure of chlorine. Chlorine has 7 valence electrons, so we need to show all these electrons. Okay, while writing electron dot structure, these are 7 electrons of chlorine. Okay children, now sodium will lose this electron, or sodium will give this electron to chlorine. After giving this electron, it will be converted into Na plus. Okay, why Na plus? Let us understand this one. Initially, it has 11 electron and 11 proton. Okay, if it will lose one electron, then there would be 10 electrons are left and protons would be 11. Okay, so it has one more positive charge in comparison to negative charge. This is the reason that sodium, after losing this electron, acquires positive charge. Means neutral atom converts into charged species. Neutral atom converts into charged species. Now come to chlorine. Initially it has 7 electrons. After gaining this electron, okay, from sodium, it converts into Cl minus. Okay, Cl minus. Okay, why? The reason is only that initially it has 17 electrons and 17 protons. After gaining one electron, it has 18 electrons and 17 protons. And as we know that protons carry positive charge and electrons carry negative charge. So the one negative charge is more in comparison to positive charge. So it converts into Cl minus. Means neutral chlorine atom converted into ion, means charged species. Now there is a difference in the charges on sodium and chlorine. Elements which acquire positive charge are called as cations. Okay, which carry positive charge are called as cations, and elements which carry negative charge, okay, they call as anions. These are called as anions. So let us write the definition of cation. Cations are those ions which carry positive charge, and anions are those ionic species which carry negative charge. Metals always forms cations because these are electropositive, and non-metals always forms anions because these are electronegative. Now Na plus and Cl minus, they will react with each other. Means there is a force of attraction developed between these one. The reason is only that both carry opposite charges, and there is a force of attraction between opposite charges. So Na plus and Cl minus, they react with each other, and there is a formation of NaCl. NaCl is the name of compound, that is sodium chloride. Okay, sodium chloride. In one molecule of sodium chloride, sodium has plus one ion, plus one charge, and chlorine has minus one charge. So by this way, sodium chloride is formed, and the force of attraction or the nature of the bond which is formed in between Na plus and Cl minus is called as electrovalent bond. This is electrovalent bond. Okay, the another term which we can give for electrovalent bond is ionic bond. So these two are similar. Electrovalent means which are made by the transfer of electrons, and ionic bond means the bond which is formed in between ions are called as ionic bond. We can write the formation of sodium to sodium plus ion conversion in equation form also. For example, in this way, sodium converts into Na plus plus one electron. Okay, this is the equation. Clear? For chlorine, chlorine atom, which is neutral in nature, when it gained one electron, it is converted into chloride ions, and this bond is called as ionic bond. Let us try to understand this concept of formation of bond compounds between matter and non-matter with one more example. Second matter, which we take is, we can take magnesium and oxygen. Okay, magnesium. The symbol of magnesium is Mg. Okay. Its atomic number of magnesium is 12. It means it has 12 electrons and 12 protons in one atom. Okay. Electronic configuration. Now we will write electronic configuration of magnesium, that is 2, 8, 2. It means its K shell has 2 electrons, L shell has 8 electrons, and M shell has 2 electrons. So which is outermost shell? Outermost shell is M shell, which is also known as valence shell. In valence shell of magnesium, the electrons which are present are 2, means 2 electrons are present in its valence shell. Now let us discuss about the second element, that is oxygen. Oxygen is a non-metal, okay, and its atomic number is 8. Atomic number of oxygen is 8. It means it has 8 electrons and 8 protons. Okay, this is the reason that oxygen atom initially it is neutral. Now we will write electronic configuration of oxygen, that is 2, 6. It has only 2 shells. First shell means K shell has 2 electrons and L shell has 6 electrons. Okay. Now both the elements, this is the valence shell for oxygen. Clear? Both the elements wants to acquire noble gas configuration. How it can acquire noble gas configuration? By losing these 2 electrons. Okay. And what is the way for oxygen? It will gain 2 electrons. Okay. By gaining of electrons, it can acquire noble gas configuration, and by losing of electrons, magnesium can acquire noble gas configuration. Clear, children? So now there is a reaction between magnesium and oxygen. What happens when magnesium and oxygen react, and in which way they react with each other? Let us understand with this one. To solve this query, first we need to draw electron dot structure of magnesium. This is the symbol of magnesium. While writing electron dot structure, we need to draw valence electrons. How many valence electrons in magnesium? 2 electrons. So here I have drawn 2 electrons for magnesium. Now if we talk about oxygen has 6 valence electrons. So in its electronic configuration, we can draw 6 dots or 6 cross. Okay. What will happen? It will lose, because by losing electrons, it can acquire noble gas configuration. So it will lose these 2 electrons, or it will donate these 2 electrons to oxygen. Clear? After losing these electrons, magnesium atom is converted into Mg plus 2 ion. Okay? Mg 2 plus. Why Mg 2 plus? Because initially it has 12 electrons and 12 protons, means neutral. But after losing 2 electrons, now it has only 10 electrons in outermost shell. But protons, number of protons are as it is, 12 protons. So if we compare these two, number of protons means positive charge is more than negative charge. So it acquires 2 plus because 2 protons are more. Oxygen, after gaining 2 electrons, it is converted into oxygen ion, and oxygen ion has 10 electrons and 8 protons. Okay, children? If we compare positive and negative charge in case of oxygen, two electrons are more, means two negative charge is more in comparison to positive charge. So it converts into O2 minus. It is positively charged, so it is called as magnesium cation. Okay, and this is called oxygen anion. Negatively charged species are called as anion, and positively charged species are called cations. So, oppositely charged, they attract with each other. There is a formation bond formed between these one. Okay, and there is a formation of magnesium oxide, MgO, in which magnesium carry positive charge 2 plus and oxygen carry 2 minus negatively charge. The name of the compound is magnesium oxide. And what is the nature of this compound? It is ionic compound, and we can say it is electrovalent compound also. So with this way, one metal reacts with another metal. I'm repeating again that while writing the formation of ionic compounds, first we need to tell about atomic number, electronic configuration, and then we have to show that Lewis dot structure of both elements, and there is a formation of compound. We can write this formation of cation and anion in equation form also. What are these equations? That Mg, it will lose electrons and converts into Mg 2 plus plus 2 electrons. Okay, and for oxygen, oxygen will gain 2 electrons, and there is a formation of oxide ion. So children, with this way we can show the formation of various ionic compounds. Let us try to show the formation of some more ionic compounds, such as magnesium chloride, MgCl2, okay, then calcium oxide, CaO, as well as sodium oxide. Children, try to show the formation of these ionic compounds and show me, send me in chat box. Then I'll tell you whether these are correct or not. This is about some of the properties of ionic compounds. The first property is that one, they are formed by ions, means ionic compounds consist ion, and these ions are positively charged ions, cations, and negatively charged anions. Second property, they have crystalline structure. What is the meaning of crystalline structure? It means there is a perfect arrangement of ions in one molecule. For example, if we talk about sodium chloride, in sodium chloride, each sodium atom is surrounded by chloride ions, and each chloride ion is surrounded by 6 sodium atoms. Okay. Next is, ionic compounds have high melting and boiling point. Why they have high melting and boiling point? The reason is only that they are formed by ions. It means Na has positive charge and Cl has negative charge. And opposite charges, they always attract each other. An ionic bond has maximum force of attraction. Means if we talk about various bonds, covalent bonds, ionic bond, van der Waals force of attraction, then out of all these one, ionic bond strength is maximum. Okay, so this is the reason they have high melting boiling point, because a large amount of energy is required to convert them in liquid state as well as in vapor state. Next is, they are good conductor of electricity. Electric current is flown with the help of electrons, with the help of ions. As we know that these compounds have ions already, their basic component is ions, so they are good conductor of electricity. Why they are good conductor of electricity? If this question arises, why they are good conductor of electricity. Okay, so the first reason is that one, because they are formed by ions, so they are good conductor of electricity. Very quite simple answer. But children, they are good conductor of electricity only in liquid state. Solid state, they are not a good conductor of electric current. Why they are not good conductor in electric current? The reason is only that in solid state, these ions are not present. These ions are formed when they convert into liquid state. As well as if we talk about electric current, then these ions can flow in liquid state easily. So they are good conductor of electric current only in aqueous solution or in molten state, not in solid state, because in solid state no ions are formed. Next is, they are soluble in polar solvent. What do you mean by polar solvent? Polar solvents are those solvents which have charges. Means, for example, water. Water has H plus and OH minus ions. Clear? So when we dissolve sodium chloride in water, it will present in this state. These water molecules, they just break down the bond between sodium and chlorine. Okay, sodium ion and chloride ion, by surrounding sodium ions with water molecules and chloride ion also surrounded by water molecules. So the bond between sodium and chlorine, it weakened due to the presence of polar solvent, means water molecules, and these ions, they easily dissolve in water. So ionic compounds are always soluble in polar solvent, whereas they are not soluble in non-polar solvent. What are non-polar solvent? Acetone. Okay, example of these one, acetone, ether. These are the examples of non-polar solvent. So children, on this paragraph, there are some of the questions can be formed. They are generally asked in board examination. First one is, why they are good conductor of electricity? Second one, why ionic compounds have high melting and boiling point? Because ionic bonds have maximum strength. Okay. Next one, ionic compounds are not good conductor of electricity in solid state, whereas in aqueous solution they are good conductor. The reason is only that one, because in aqueous solution the ions are formed, whereas in solid state the ions are not formed. Okay, so this is the reason that they are good conductor of electricity in aqueous state only. Next question, which can be formed on this paragraph, that ionic compounds are soluble in polar solvent, whereas these are insoluble in non-polar solvent. Because in the presence of polar solvent like water, ionization, or we can say polarization of these molecules takes place, whereas in the presence of non-polar solvent, these are non-polar solvent, in the presence of non-polar solvent, ionization does not take place. So these are very small questions which can be asked during in board examination. So this is all about ionic compounds today.